Bonjour Cathy, j'espère que tu vas bien. La dernière fois, nous avions fait cette petite leçon. Donc ça, c'est la page 14 du livre Grammaire progressive du français, niveau débutant. Ils sont grands, elles sont grandes. Max est grand, il est blond. Léa est grande, elle est blonde. Max et Léo sont grands, ils sont blonds. Léa et Ada sont grandes, elles sont blondes. Max, Ada et Léa sont blonds, ils sont blonds. Mixed group, masculine form. OK? Masculine plural form. So, elles sont blondes, Ada et Léa, two girls or two women. Ils sont blonds, Max et Léo, or Max et Léa. A man, two men, or one woman and one guy. OK? So this is a mixed group, so it's going to be masculine. So in general, we just add an S. Hein? If it's a plural form, we add an S. We add an E if it's a feminine form. Okay? So let's be careful of the S and X. We don't have a change. If it's il est français, we just add an E for the feminine form. Elle est française. Il est vieux, we saw that. Elle est vieille. But if it's just a masculine plural form, it's going to be the same. Il est français, ils sont français. Il est vieux, ils sont vieux. Il est beau, ils sont beaux. So the nouns ending in the AU, EAU, the plural form will be with an X. So now there are some different exercises that you can go through. And you add an S, etc. It's really not difficult, seriously, here. You just have to be careful of those guys. You know, when they end with an EAU, you need to add an X, okay? If it's just masculine plural. Now, we know to be, être. Ok, je suis, tu es, il est, elle est, on est. Nous sommes, vous êtes, ils sont, elles sont. So be careful of on est. There's still, it's a group, hein? It's not one person. So it can be we or everybody, etc. So it's a group of people. On est italien. We can add an S here. Ok, the adjective depend on the subject. On est italienne. OK? It can be feminine pluriel. It can be masculine pluriel. OK? Il est jeune, elle est jeune. Okay. So, vous, tu, you know the difference. But just be careful of the adjectives. OK? Vous êtes prêt, masculine singular. Vous êtes prête, féminine singular. OK? Now, tu, we know it's only singular. But if I have vous as a pluriel form, because it's a group of people, vous êtes prêt, vous êtes prête. Masculine pluriel, féminine pluriel. On can be nous, okay? But it also means everybody, tout le monde. It's a generality, okay? Here for the present tense, we're going to use the singular form. Quand on est enrhumé, on est fatigué. Enrhumé is like to have a sore throat, to be sick, to have a cold. We are tired, okay? We can also say, nous en France, on aime le fromage. We in France, we like. It's like us in French, in France, okay? But I'm translating in order for, you know, for making sense. But logically in English, we could say us in France, we like cheese, okay? So here it's not difficult. It's just about conjugating to be. So, but we have to be careful of the adjective. Brun is to have brown hair. Grande, ton, feminine form. Petit, short, small. Singular form and masculine form. Célibataire, single. Marié, married. It can also be a feminine form. It's the same pronunciation. Fatigué, tired. Gentil, gentille. Be careful of the double L and it's a y sound. Gentille. OK? Je suis contente d'être à Paris. So, être triste de partir, to be sad, to leave. Je suis désolée d'être en retard. I'm sorry to be late. Je suis heureuse d'être en vacances. I'm happy to be on vacation. Okay? Être au chômage is to be unemployed. Être enrhumé is to have a cold. Être pressé is to be in a hurry. Okay? So now, I think we did up to, we talked about that. Remember that est-ce que is very common in French. That means many French use est-ce que for asking questions. You don't have to. Hein? You can use it if you feel comfortable, but many people cannot pronounce this expression very well. So they just drop it. So they're like, you know what, I'm not going to say est-ce que in French because it's a tiny bit too complex for me to say it. So, but you can just have a normal sentence, like for instance, vous êtes japonais. Vous êtes japonais, it's a statement. Jean est français. It's a statement. But here it's a question. Vous êtes japonais? Jean est français? Okay. Negative form, we know that, sorry, ne pas will surround the verb. Okay, any kind of verb. It can also be an apostrophe. Je ne suis pas content. I'm not happy. Elle n'est pas riche. She's not rich. Ils ne sont pas italiens. They are not Italian. Okay? So, ne jamais, never. Ne plus, no longer, not anymore. Remember those guys. Ne pas, not. Ne jamais, never. Ne plus, no longer. Okay? So, you can also go through those guys. Je ne suis pas grande. Je ne suis pas française. Je ne suis pas bilingue. Bilingue. Je ne suis pas prof. You can also have the contraction. It's fine. Le lit n'est pas confortable. It's not comfortable. L'eau n'est pas chaude. The water is not hot. And les chambres ne sont pas chères. The rooms are not expensive. Okay. Now, we saw that the ER verbs, what's the first group? So, usually, if it's a regular verb, like for instance, aimer, parler, regarder, etc., we drop the ER and we're going to replace the ER with the following endings. E, E-S, E, O-N-S, E-Z, E-N-T. Okay? So for instance, je regarde, tu regardes, il regarde, nous regardons, vous regardez, il regarde. Okay? It's a E sound. So, je regarde la télé, je mange un gâteau, j'écoute la radio, je téléphone à Martha, j'aime les gâteaux, j'aime Martha. Okay? So, here, we have parler, je parle, regarder, je regarde, manger, je mange, téléphoner, je téléphone, aimer, écouter, pardon, écouter is j'écoute, aimer is j'aime, étudier is j'étudie. Okay? So, aimer is very, very big, be careful. You remember the last time that when we say j'aime Jean, j'aime Paris, j'aime mon mari, j'aime les carottes, j'aime mon chien, j'aime la musique. But be careful. If you talk about an object, you know, especially food, wine, cheese, j'aime ça. Okay? If you want to replace j'aime les carottes, j'aime ça. J'aime la musique, j'aime ça. J'aime Paris. That's it. You're not going to replace Paris. J'aime mon mari, je l'aime. J'aime mon chien, je l'aime. Okay? J'aime Jean, je l'aime bien. Okay? Je l'aime bien, he's more friendly. So, okay, after I'll go through the transcript. Here, I don't think we did everything. Ah, yeah, yeah, yes, we did it. So, second part, here, parler, it's an ER verb, so we know how to conjugate it. And so, je parle, tu parles, il parle, nous parlons, vous parlez. Il ou elle parle, okay? So, here, it's just easy, okay? So, be careful of où on, Igor et moi, on parle le russe, c'est le groupe. En Russie, on parle russe, okay? It's a generality. So, vous parlez anglais, non, je ne parle pas anglais. Vous habitez en France, non, je n'habite pas en France. Est-ce que Marie travaille? Non, elle ne travaille pas. Est-ce que Paul et Max étudient? Non, ils n'étudient pas, okay? So here, just be careful of the verbs ending in C-E-R and G-E-R. C-E-R, we're going to add a C-C-D. Okay, so je commence, tu commences, il commence, but nous commençons. Hein? We need to have this sound. Vous commencez, il ou elle commence. After we have nager, so we're going to keep the E with nous. Je nage, tu nages, il nage, nous nageons, vous nagez, il ou elle nage. Okay? So now, acheter, so we're going to go back to this, okay, because I don't want to saturate you with a lot of information, but here we need to change the accent, the position of the accent, so préférer, acheter, so préférer, in this group we have espérer, répéter, compléter, so you see the two accents here on the same, but if I conjugate it, I'm going to change one, je préfère, tu préfères, il préfère, And after, we come back to the infinitive form. Nous préférons, vous préférez, il préfère. Okay? So préférer, espérer, répéter, compléter will have the same pattern. So préférer to prefer, espérer to hope, répéter to repeat, compléter to complete. Okay? Acheter will have, we don't have an accent here, you see? So, but I'm going to have to add an accent when I conjugate this verb. So acheter, but j'achète, tu achètes, il achète, nous achetons, vous achetez, ils ou elles achètent. Okay? So in the same group, we have mener, amener, emmener, enlever, peser. So acheter is to buy. But mener is to lead. It depends on the context as well, but in general, it will be to lead, L-E-A-D. Amener, emmener is to bring along, depending on if it's an object or a person. Enlever, to remove, peser, to weigh. Now, concerning the verbs like jeter, to throw. So, je jette, tu jettes, il jette, nous jetons, vous jetez, il jette, elle jette. So, look at something. So, I double the consonant with je, tu, il, and il ou elle, pluriel. But I'm going to keep the infinitive form with nous and vous. Okay? It's to throw, or to toss. Appeler, to call. Not je m'appelle is my name is. Hein? But j'appelle is to call someone. Or j'appelle, tu appelles, il appelle, nous appelons, vous appelez, ils appellent. Okay? So look at something. I double the consonant with everything except with nous and vous. Okay? We are not doing that right now. We need to talk about that the next time. Now, concerning the transcript, I didn't finish yet, hein, so you're going to receive the pages. But comme d'habitude, as usual, parfois nous prenons, sometimes we take. So this is literally the transcription. This is what we did together. Okay? So there is always, when we start the class, we always talk about something. Okay? But you know how to give me the time, the date, the weather, so you don't have any problems on this level. Okay? After so many courses, you know, that will be sad to not being able to tell the date or the time. Okay, but you can. There's no problem here. So now, le métro. So parfois nous prenons le métro. Dans le métro, est-ce qu'il y a souvent du monde? Du monde is crowded, a lot of people. Oui, il y a beaucoup de monde. Yeah, it's crowded, there's a lot of people. So le matin et le soir aussi. Quel est le meilleur moyen de transport à Hong Kong? The best way of transportation, best means of transportation. Moyen is a mean or a way. The best transportation in Hong Kong. So, tu conduis, you drive. Tu m'avais dit oui, but tu préfères prendre le métro. Conduire, bon, c'est ennuyant. Il n'y a pas beaucoup de choses économiques à Hong Kong. Okay. I would say, you know, with, maybe it's not really practical and also it's too expensive to have the car and to park the car in Hong Kong. So, tu aimerais conduire à Hong Kong. So what I'm going to do here is to move it here. Otherwise, it's not going to make any sense. We can have une majuscule. Voilà. C'était plus facile de conduire à Dubaï. Il y a moins de monde. Les rues sont plus grandes. Okay. Il y a beaucoup d'autoroutes. C'est plus facile de circuler. C'est plus facile à circuler. You can see both, it's fine. C'est plus facile de circuler. Il y a... Alors, ici... ici, il y a beaucoup de trafic... Just one F, sorry. Ou alors beaucoup d'embouteillage, because you need to learn this word. Il y a beaucoup d'embouteillage, ok. Beaucoup de bouchons. Can be that as well. Ok. Et traffic jam, hein, basically. C'est énervant, it's annoying. So be careful of gentil. You know the pronunciation of gentil. There's still an L, but I don't pronounce it. And gentille. Malheureux, malheureuse. If I want the feminine form. Curieux, curieuse. So we still change, but if it's a feminine form. And be careful of the pronunciation of neveur. Okay? Not neufeur, but neveur. 10 heures. Now, la chaleur, you told me that it was very, very hot. This is from vocabulary, so we don't have to repeat this stuff. Okay, that's from the book, I think it was vocabulary. No, grammar, sorry. Grammar progressive du français. Okay. So now, coming back to our transcript, est-ce que tu te souviens quand tu étais petite à Hong Kong? So those are the pages. Maybe we can say up to 25. Okay, so ideally, so I can say grammar progressive. I would say ideally trying to do the pages. So exercice 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, page 25. Okay? Donc, on va l'écrire. Les devoirs. Exercice 1, 2, 3, page 25. Grammaire progressive. The one, the beginner one. Which is not really a beginner. Se souvenir is to remember. Okay, oui, je me souviens. Yes, I remember. Okay. Ah, it doesn't want to write correctly. Mon enfance, my childhood, mon enfance. Okay. Or a childhood, if you want. Oui, je me souviens de mon enfance. I remember my childhood. C'était une bonne enfance. OK. C'était une bonne enfance. Or you can say, j'étais heureuse. J'ai eu une enfance heureuse. Une bonne enfance ou une enfance heureuse. OK. Comment sont les profs en général à Hong Kong? Comparé à la Chine, ils sont stricts, ok. Mais donc en France, nous avons des profs qui peuvent crier ou des profs qui peuvent être un peu violents, d'accord. Donc c'est interdit à Hong Kong, luckily. Certains profs sont-ils violents à Hong Kong? Non, c'est interdit. C'est bien. It's very good because it's not acceptable. I used to have a primary teacher who was hurting me. And pretty much every day. And she was making fun of my grandmother because my grandmother was not a native speaker. And so she was making fun of my grandmother, my family, and she was hurting me. And that was, I think I was maybe third or fourth grade, something like that, fourth grade, something like that. And that was a very mean teacher, and I never wanted to see her again, ever again in my life. So that was traumatizing for a lot of French, actually, and that's why now the French parents, they tend to be very controlling of what the teacher can do to their kids. Anyway, donc les devoirs 1, 2, 3, page 25. Ok, grammaire progressive. Ici, on a vocabulaire progressif, page 84. Donc, on va voir un peu c'est où. C'était là. Vocabulaire progressif, page 84. Yeah, we just did one part. Ok. Donc, quelques fêtes et traditions. Il y a beaucoup de jours fériés en France. On ne travaille pas ces jours-là. That days. Il existe des fêtes religieuses et des fêtes civiles. Donc, à Pâques, on offre des œufs en chocolat. À Noël, on a un sapin de Noël et on offre des cadeaux. Le 1er janvier, le jour de l'an, on souhaite la bonne année. On souhaite la bonne année ou on envoie des cartes de vœux, so greeting cards, aux personnes qu'on aime bien, to the people that we like. Le 1er mai, la fête du travail, on offre une fleur, le muguet, c'est like a small white flower. Le 14 juillet, la fête nationale, il y a un défilé militaire, un feu d'artifice, fireworks, et un bal. Le jour des rois, le 6 janvier, n'est pas férié, so it's not a day off, mais on mange un bon gâteau, la galette des rois. Okay, that is it. Au revoir, Katie, passe une bonne semaine et on se voit samedi prochain. Bye bye.